No smiley, David, this is serious.
It's early.
Short and quick. I got an appointment I gotta run to. Pardon the pun. So let's make it just three. So here we go. The first thing I wish I had known before I started running was I wish I had known proper training methods. So instead of going out fast and killing it on every single run, it would have been nice to be able to kind of slowly lead into it. Yes, I started off with walking. However, I ended up running way too fast for all of my easy runs, like fast for my fast runs, and fast all the time. So it's no wonder that I pretty much burned out. So that would be the first thing, is just slow it down, go at a nice, nice, steady heart rate. 180 minus your age works wonders. And I've talked about it on a past episode, I think that's what it is. So that would be that. Number two, I wish I had known about Glide or Squirrel's Nut Butter. Like, seriously, that stuff just makes me very happy. You know, when you sweat and you're running and you've got friction going in places that really you don't want to talk to your wife about or your friends about, that's where Glide comes in. And I love this stuff. I just put it on. You can put it on, especially for guys, right? You can put it on your nipples instead of putting band-aids on. It stops the chafing. So when you sweat, rubbing on the shirt, you know, you don't want to have bloody nipples. I mean, it sucks. I've been there, done it. Wish I had known about it sooner before I started running. So that's that's one that I would highly recommend. And it's cheap. I mean, I don't know. It's like, lasts for a while. It may not be extremely cheap. Maybe like $19 or $13 for Glide. Just depends on the Squirrel's Nut Butter, if you can get it. I think you can get it on Amazon. And the third one would be proper running shoes. I ran in a shoe that was a Saucony, and I thought it was good. And you know what? I busted out the uppers really fast. Like, the lady was asking me at the store, and I was like, I thought it was fine. But man, when after running for a while, I busted through the uppers. My toes were really squished. I got a couple of blisters. Saucony I found was just too tight, but I didn't know the difference, and I kept buying them year after year after year, and like, man, this sucks. And then I finally found a really good pair of Ultras. Right, they're zero drop. I didn't even know about what drop was, but zero drop were from the heel to the front. There is no difference, right? It's just flat right across. It's the same height, same stack height. So in doing so, they also have, a big toe box. So when your feet land on the ground, they're not squished like this. They can actually spread out and kind of land on the ground, and you've got space between them, you can wiggle them. It works wonders, especially because your feet are gonna swell. So there's room in there. So absolutely highly recommend getting the right size pair of running shoes, the right type of running shoe for you, because if you've got a big heel, right, and you've got like an 8 millimeter drop, which is what I had, you tend to want to land on your heel like you would walk, right? But when you're running, you don't have proper running form if you're landing on your heel, right? You want the center of your mass landing right kind of where your hips are. So anyways, I wish I'd known that. So those are my three, guys. Proper running shoes, number one. Now, if you're getting ultras, they do work your calf muscle extremely well. So you kind of have to go slow on them. And so I wish I had bought those shoes at the very beginning. I have them now, and they have worked amazing. So, okay, you guys, I'm out of here. I gotta go. I gotta run. I will see you, I guess, tomorrow. Hopefully you're enjoying the videos, and I do appreciate all the likes, comments, and all the love that you send my way. Take care of everyone. Bye for now. See ya. The sun came out. How awesome is that? Oh, let there be sunshine in my world. See, I always told you there was sunshine in my world.